Mells with Superficial Gallery, and welcome to episode 28 of 31 Days with the King. This is a short series dedicated to all things Stephen King, with a daily upload on one of his works. Now, we will try our best to incorporate his most popular titles, as well as some of the ones that are lesser known or weren't as well received. So with that, let's get started with today's pick, and it is Four Past Midnight. This is kind of a larger book here, so I want to make sure I get it in the frame the best I can. Now, if you've been following the series, let me put it that way, you'll know that I reviewed different seasons earlier on. And I told you in that video that Different Seasons is a tie with another short story collection for my favorite collection by Stephen King. And here we are. We are at the one that is the tie for Different Seasons, Four Past Midnight. Now, Four Past Midnight contains four stories, much like Different Seasons. And these are some of the best short stories, in my opinion, that Stephen King has put out. You might have heard of a couple that are in here. I feel like there's one that's in here that's highly underrated. And then I think there's another one in here that people might be familiar with, but I don't actually see a lot of things out there about it. So with that, let's go ahead and get started. Now, what I am going to do is this in the same format for time's sake, and I'm going to read the synopsis of each story from the dust jacket. Okay, I will keep this as spoiler-free as possible, as always, but once I go through what the dust jacket gives the explanation of each story, I will kind of go a little bit into the meat, and then the two that have the adaptations, we'll talk about that as well. Okay, so with that, let's get started. And pardon me, I will be looking away a little bit as I read what we have as the description for each of these stories. Okay, so One Past Midnight, the Langoliers takes a red-eye flight from L.A. to Boston in a most unfriendly sky. Only 11 passengers survive, but landing in an eerily empty world makes them wish they hadn't. Something's waiting for them, you see. Now, that's extremely spoiler-free, to be honest. The kind of overall gist of what the story is these people take this red-eye flight, okay? And the most spoilery thing that I'm going to give you is that at some point during the flight, they seem to pass through a time jump or a time warp or some type of portal where they are no longer in the universe that they are most familiar with. Okay, now, when they land at the airport, that's when the creepy stuff, as if, you know, being abandoned in the air isn't creepy enough, because I have serious terror of flying. That's when some of the real creepy stuff starts happening. This novel is really heavy-handed on supernatural tropes, okay? And that's why I enjoy it. The supernatural part of the story is really gripping, and so I would highly suggest it if you have not read this story. Each one of these stories, I would go ahead and buy the whole, you know, short story collection. But if you prefer to collect them individually, I know that they're out there as individual stories, and they're also available on Audible individually as well. Okay. Now, the Langoliers did get a two-part TV, made-for-TV adaptation. I personally didn't mind the adaptation. I remember watching it in real time, like in real life, and I was pretty impressed. Now, I was younger when this was going on. I would love to watch it again as an adult. I have to say I have not done that. I've only seen it once. But from what I can recall and the feeling I got from the adaptation was that they kept pretty close to the source material, maybe changing a couple of things up, but it's actually one of the better adaptations of one of King's works that's out there. So definitely give that a check out as well if you can find it. And you know, if you can find it, comment below and let me know where, because I'd love to watch it again. It's probably on DVD. Anywho, 2 past midnight, secret window, secret garden, enters the suddenly strange life of writer Mort Rainey, recently divorced, depressed, and alone on the shore of Tashmore Lake. Alone, that is, until a figure named John Shooter arrives, pointing an accusing finger. Now, this story has horror, and it has supernatural, okay? What I enjoyed about this story is it is about Mort Rainey. He's going through a really tough time in his life. He retreats off to a lake house because he really wants to write a new story, okay? He has a little bit of a writer's block, and then Mr. Shooter shows up, okay, and basically accuses him of plagiarizing this story that he had published in a prior publication, okay? That's as far as I'm going to go on this because, again, heavy-handed on supernatural and horror. I really suggest that you check it out. This does have a film adaptation, and for me personally, it was one of the adaptations that I really, truly enjoyed. Now, they did a really big plot change and twist at the end, so if you're more familiar with the adaptation than you are the novella, I would suggest you go and read the novella to get the actual book ending to Mort Rainey and this Secret Window, Secret Garden. Now, Secret Window did star Johnny Depp, and it had Timothy Hutton, I believe. Let's see. Yes, who, y'all, I think I've already told y'all I really like him. It also has John Turturro. I know I probably didn't pronounce that correctly because y'all probably learned by now that I'm not good with names. But I love him. He is a phenomenal actor, and he really brings the creep factor into this story. Now, a real fun fact about this story is that King wrote it because he himself has been accused many times of plagiarism. I think someone actually tried to accuse him of stealing the story of Misery, which was our very first episode of the season. So, do give this a read. I think you will really enjoy it. Moving along to 3 Past Midnight, The Library Policeman. Is set in Junction City, Iowa, an unlikely place for evil to be hiding. But for small businessman Sam Peebles, who thinks he might be losing his mind, another enemy is hiding there as well, the truth. If he can find it in time, he might stand a chance. Now, Library Policeman, in my opinion, is a very underrated short story by Stephen King. It is heavy on supernatural. Okay, so I'll go ahead and tell you that. And Library Policeman, in my opinion, it gets to the story pretty quickly, so I don't want to spoil a lot for you. Just know that the character goes to a library because he needs help preparing for a speech. And this is when the supernatural parts really start to pick up in the story. I highly, highly suggest this one as well. Big surprise, I'm going to highly suggest everyone that's in this series. So moving along to 4 Past Midnight, the flat surface of a Polaroid photograph becomes, for 15-year-old Kevin Delavan, an invitation to the supernatural. Old Pop Merrill, Castle Rock's sharpest trader, wants to crash the party for profit. But the Sundog is a creature that shouldn't exist at all and is a very dangerous investment. Okay, the Sundog. If you are watching season 2 of Castle Rock, you know that the Merrills are, you know, featured this season. A really funny nod to the Sundog in one of the first episodes of Castle Rock is when we first see Pop Merrill. He is working on an old Polaroid camera, and he takes a photo with it, which I think is a great callback to this story. Now, heavy on the supernatural, the entity that starts appearing in these photographs, because what ends up happening is the young man takes in the camera to Pop's shop because every time he takes a picture, this weird thing is seen in every one of them. And every subsequent photo, it's like it's getting closer and closer and closer. So the creep factor on this is very high, okay? What I like about it is the entity or that supernatural thing that's showing up in the photos and what comes out of it. So, if you are a fan of the Merrills and you're looking for something Castle Rock and something featuring pop, I highly suggest you check this one out. There's no adaptations on this or The Library Policeman, but the novels or the novellas are super, super interesting, and I would highly recommend it. So, thank you for coming along the Four Past Midnight ride with me. I wouldn't be me if I didn't show you the photo on the back. And it's a tried and true one. We've seen it before, but he's still devilishly handsome. Love this man. Make sure you subscribe to Superficial Gallery and hit the bell to get notified when new content is posted. Like the video, comment below if you have read any of these, not just the whole collection, but any of these stories, or you have seen the film adaptations. I'd love to talk to folks about the things that they changed in the adaptations. So comment that below. We've got just a few days left in this series, but if you have something that you'd like to see covered that has not already been done so, please feel free to drop that in the comments as well, or tweet me at MellsBells84. We'd be happy to fit it in. And as always, I will be back to haunt y'all tomorrow. Bye. Aww.